In this video, we're going to look at how to use a TI-84 to graph a piecewise defined function and then use that function to calculate some values. So here's our piecewise defined function, and we're going to go over to our graphing calculator, and we're going to go into the y equals. And now, if I graph x squared minus 1, and we'll do all this in a standard window to start, and we might change it as we go. So zoom 6 will always put you in a standard window. I get the whole function, but the way a piecewise defined function works is it's only x squared minus 1 when x is less than negative 1. So I need to put that in there. So that's what I'm going to show you how to do. Now, parentheses are going to be very important here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to insert a parenthesis before the x squared and close the parentheses after the 1. And now I'm going to open a set of parentheses because now I need to give it that restriction that x has to be less than negative 1. So where you find that is under above the math key. You do second test, which is above your math key, and there's all your inequalities. We have strictly less than negative 1. We'll close those parentheses, and now let's see what happens when we graph. Notice we only get the piece that's to the left of negative 1. So that's how we do that first piece. Now the next part, we have 0 in between negative 1 and 2. Now because you won't be able to see it on this graphing calculator, I'm going to graph something a little different for now, and we'll change it to 0 when we go to evaluate our function. Let's do it at negative 1, from negative 1 to 2, because I want you to see that piece of the graph. So I go down here, and if all I'm putting in is a constant, I don't need the parentheses. So I'm going to do negative 1 for now. Like I said, I'll change that back to 0 when we go to evaluate the function. I just want you to see the piece of the graph. Now the one thing that's different, we cannot put negative 1 less than or equal to x less than 2 all together. We have to do them both separate. So we do negative 1, remember it's second test, less than or equal to is number 6. Then our x, then we close the parentheses, and we'll need to open another set to do x less than 2. So x, second test, strictly less than is number 5, 2. Let's take a look at our graph now. And there, put in the line. Again, the reason I did that is so you could see the graph, because once we put it at 0, you won't be able to see it. It'll be right on the x-axis. Our last piece, you probably have a pretty good idea of how this is going to go. We're going to want to use parentheses. And then we have 4x minus 4. And there's our piece of the function in there. And then this is 4x second test, greater than is number 3, 2, and we should have all our pieces in there, and we get that linear piece up here. Now I have a video as well for doing this by hand so you can compare the two graphs. What we need to do is we do need to put that one back to 0 before we start evaluating at values. So I'm going to just go in here, change that to 0, and I need to delete out that 1, and we'll go back to our graph, and there's our three pieces. Again, you can't really see that piece where x equals 0 just because of the x is on the x-axis. Now what we can do to calculate those values, now we're down to the second part, they asked us for f of negative 3. That's the output when x equals negative 3, so you do second calculate value, negative 3, enter, and you get 8. We can do that again for each of these inputs. So second calculate value, negative 1. And we get 0 because when x is equal to negative 1, the function is 0. We'll just finish this one off just to make sure we get all our values. Our value at 0, also 0. Second calculate value, at 2 gives us a 0. Now this is something to be wary of, and you can't always trust the calculator because our function is undefined at 2. So you got to be a little bit careful about that. The calculator is giving us back 0, but technically our function is undefined at 2. So sometimes the calculator doesn't always give us the right answer. Let's get our last one. So I can calculate value at 3. And you'll notice it gives us 0 again, which is not correct. It's on the wrong piece of the function. It should actually be up here. So calculating the values with the graphing calculator, you do have to be a little bit careful. Graphing calculator has a little bit of trouble calculating values of a piecewise defined function. It's important that you know which piece you want to be on. So that's how we can graph a piecewise defined function with the graphing calculator. And as you saw, finding values can be a little tricky. Sometimes it might be easier to just do it by hand, but it can be done with a graphing calculator.